Good evening.
Hi.
Good evening. It's a pleasure to be here today evening and can share with you two brilliant entrepreneurs. We have done a lot and going to do a lot. I'm going to be very short and sharp and talk about in a very personal way as I know them, not about their professional experiences and entrepreneurial experiences or what they've done in their life. I will share with you my personal notes on them, and they'll talk about themselves. They're the best people to talk about themselves. I'll share first about Deepayan. I have known Deepayan for probably about a year and 6 months, a little bit closely. I found him to be extremely dynamic, full of brimming with energy, wants to do things. He's an ex-IIT KGP, and he has, I think, indulged into an entrepreneurial life right after he took off from IIT, correct? And then, it's a tough path, it's a tough call for most IIT graduates, but to move on to become an entrepreneur is an exception. And most people don't do that because they go get a job, but you have a few exceptions in the Thai, fraternity in Kolkata, and I'm sure many other places in the country, but I'm sure we're glad to have people like Deepayan in the Thai fraternity who had just passed out about a few years back, 5 years back if I recall, 6 years back if I recall correctly, and put together this great and interesting and small, all combined together, enterprise which focuses on providing special solutions which is audiovisual in nature, which is animation combined together for the engineering companies in the country. And he has a wide list of clients. And I will not tell much about Deepayan. What I can tell you about him is that he's full of energy, he's brimming with energy, he wants to make things happen. He has taken up one of our interesting portal called Jamela.in. A very interesting one. Very interesting one to share this. The name is jhamela.in. If you are in any Jamela in Kolkata, in which to say that you don't know how to get things done, which you don't want to get things done, get onto the website of JHAMELA. I'm sure they will talk a little bit about it. I was one of his first clients, and he was very prompt to come back to me to say that I'll get your driving license done, which is pending to be done or renewed or whatever it is, and some other stuff. So Deepayan, glad to have you on board for this excellent evening where you can talk about yourself, what you've done, your struggle, and get us all excited. Thank you. And the time.
Yes.
Right.
Sure.
Now 7:03, and since I have only 15 minutes, I think I will straight on focus to the point which matters the most, that is Healthy Technology Private Limited, what we do at Healthy Technology Private Limited. Sir, the one thing that I particularly feel is common to most of us who are present here is, if I look into it, that what is the thing that I would really connect to a lot of people? Some of us are entrepreneurs, some of us senior decision makers in the governments, big corporation. So I think it is the wealth part which is very much common. And if I can borrow the thought process from Mr. Vikram Das Gupta, then sir, some senior people who have already made it big, they are into the mode of wealth distribution. And then the next level, the senior people who are senior to us are into the phase of wealth creation, and people like us who are just working very hard right now is in the phase of making money. So the point is that if these are the things that we want to do, the actual point that we want to make is how, I mean, what it takes to create this particular amount of wealth. So if I look at it as an organizational point of view, I would particularly say a very strong product or service with a powerful value proposition. This is extremely important for most of the organizations to, you know, get into the wealth process. A passionate team, of course, an effective marketing, and investments at certain points of time. But the point is that if these things are made right, say they have all been made right, now how exactly this team or organization is going to communicate to its stakeholders, clients, investors, or for that matter, whosoever, is important that they have done it. For example, say HCC, they have built this fantastic bridge, super mega structure in Bandra Worli Sea Link in Bombay. How would they communicate it to their rightful audience? Or how would Larsen & Toubro communicate to its audience that they have made the nuclear core for Takrapar nuclear power plant? Or for that matter, NCC has constructed the India's largest nuclear power plant reactor buildings as of now. Similarly, there are endless products which are there. Like for example, Larsen & Toubro has constructed the MHN, Mumbai High North Oil Rig. They have constructed or fabricated it in Oman, transported it through sea and erected it in Mumbai. Now, they have the basic mediums that we understand for communication. The communication is the word. News and television, advertisements, print magazines, print media, basic pattern magazines and newspapers, PR events and trade shows and meets. But the question is, how did they do it? Now, at this point of time, say one of my friends, say Rahul, is representing Hindustan Construction Company, and he has used all the platforms that I have mentioned to let people know that, see, we have done Bandra Worli Sea Link. And Mr. Bikram Dasgupta, sir, if I may use you for an example, is representing government in the eastern region on a very big corporation who has some projects. Now, at this particular point of time, Bikram Dasgupta and Rahul meet at certain place, and Mr. Dasgupta says, well, Rahul, I think you have done a good job. Tell me how you did do it, because I have something in mind. If it works out well, we'll go for it. So, what can Rahul do? Now, friends, this is serious business. This is where Mr. Dasgupta is going to give a great opportunity for Rahul to do it. But the issue is, how would Rahul do it? He may think about, you know, making a film during the project, which he will show to Mr. Dasgupta, sir, we did this. And that is going to be a, I don't know how many hours, 3 hours, 4 hours film, if it is made into a film. Or he might give him a project report. He does not have time for that. And last but not the least, he might take him for a site visit, which is practically even the worst idea, I would say. Because for Rahul, this is an opportunity, but for Mr. Dasgupta, he is the kind of a person who is senior, he has a very less time and he has a very small window. Rahul is a very small window. So at this stage, the level of communication that I'm talking about is where we call communication 2.0. And I would term it as visual communication film, but there are many various names. Somebody call it explainer, somebody call it, I mean, whatever it is. But we call it visual communication film, a 5 to 10 minute, maximum 15 minute film, which will talk about the entire project or the product in details, almost covering everything. And Mr. Dasgupta will be impressed. Okay, this is how you did it. This is the grand thing. So now this is where I would like to show one small film. Now this, say Rahul will ask Mr. Dasgupta, please sit down in our boardroom, have a cup of tea. And that is where he is explaining that this is Bandra Worli Sea Link. This is how it is going to look like after it is completed. Or now that it has been done, he can make it to himself whether it looks like when it is completed. Now the point is, this is the kind of films that we make at Anthelian Technology. This kind of a film will in the first glow say, okay, this is the entire project, how it looks, how it is going to give the feel, what is the feel of the particular stuff. The second part of this video is going to talk how they have built this particular project. Now this is where the actual engineering visualization comes. Say they choose by a point, by a method called method of triangulation. There they take a jack-up platform using a barge.
The jacks are put to the seabed so that the platform gets fixed there, like this. Then the cylinder is put. The cylinder goes by its own weight up to the soft sides. After this, we use a vibro hammer to push it through the soft rock bed, like this. Then they will seal the through concrete that connecting point, like this. And then they will use the RCB drill to drill into the hard rock bed. Now, in this particular case, these machines are absolutely as per the machine drawing and to scale. Now they put the reinforcement bars, they will put concrete through concrete pump, and this is how one pile is created. At a particular spot, four such piles are created. Now they create a dam called a coffer dam. In this coffer dam, which is still the seabed, they put low grade sand and low grade concrete so that most of the water comes out and the base gets stronger. The rest of the water which remains there is removed through pump, like this, and then they create a pile cap and then piers are constructed. So this is how every single pillar has been constructed in that entire Mahim Bay of Bandra Valley segment. Now comes how they will create the segment. Now this particular machine, they call it the launching truss. It's a 1200 ton machine which has been constructed just for the sake of this project. And there are five legs which move in exactly this particular order. So after this moves, now this segment is completed, they have to do this segment. So this is, I'm showing one film to give an idea of what is called an engineering visualization film or a visual communication film. Now this has moved, now what they will do, they will hang these elements. Now this is the largest trailer you could have possibly seen. So you can understand what is the size of these castings. These concrete castings are first made to hang. There are 17 such castings which are first made to hang, and then they will glue it through industrial adhesive to complete this region. Till that time, these cables will be holding it. Now after gluing it, they will put five set of steel cables through them, like knitting. Only after the whole thing gets into a one single unit, solid stuff, then only they will transfer the load. After that, they will remove these cables. So this is how this thing proceeds. Just to have a little bit of idea. So this is how they are first adding it, and then they will put it, like this. So this is how the entire thing has proceeded. Now I would like to end this particular story here and take you to the next couple of stories which I will not show in much detail. This is for the MHN Mumbai High North oil and gas rigs. See, now these are all underwater stuff. This is just for marketing my name and my client's name, leaving that aside. This is called a jacket. A jacket is a kind of a 27 story structure on which the entire platform sits, the oil rig sits.
Today, which have to be dumped out from beneath the oceans. One of the top names daring into this sector is Larsen & Toubro Limited.
This is the MHN rig, and these are all drawn accurate to scale as per their drawings. Now what I'm trying to show is you the quality of animation. We call it near natural animation or movie quality animation. Now I don't know how it will look if how would I do if I try to do a movie, but at least I can say as far as engineering is concerned, I can create near natural. And this is in Oman where they are fabricating this. This is the L&T's yard, 400,000 square kilometer feet of yard of L&T where they are constructing this and where they are fabricated. And now you see this is how we are showcasing how this has been constructed, and this is the timeline adding the fourth dimension, that is time dimension, to the entire project. What will L&T do with this particular film? He will take it and show it to all the oil and gas companies who are trying to lay rigs and say, hey boss, all my competitors make a jacket of this type, which is say 13,500 metric tons, more than 10,000 in 1.5 years. We do it in 10 months. This is how we have done it. And the nitty-gritty, if they do it, try to do it with just videography, it will be very difficult. They will have to hold the camera for 10 months during that time, and then also these are so big inside, it becomes disconnected. So these are the facilities of animation. But then, this is one I just like to show for Pranapar nuclear power. This is for Kudankulam nuclear power plant. Did some cinematography and stuff for Antalyan, like this, but forgetting that. This is the nuclear power plant, which is the reactor buildings, and the hydro structure is constructed by Hindustan Construction Company. And we have done it, made this film for them. And this is how the reactor core is being made. This is the steel dome, and then they have used all the latest technologies, or I would say the first time in India technologies like this is called pre-stressing. Even if there is a missile attack, nothing will happen. If in Fukushima there was a problem because of tsunami, people could not get in, and the reactor core temperature was going high and people were scared that it might burst. But we have PHRS here called passive heat removal system. So these, how they are going to work, what are the steps of fabrication, construction of very high-end animation, high-precision engineering processes we show in 10 minutes. This is the kind of stuff that we are doing. Now, so far I have shown you the films which are purely animation in nature. Say, Tata Steel is fabricating steel tubes in Jamshedpur plant. Now again here, if I try only to show through videography, through animation, if I try to show it through videography, the problem will be that it is such a long plant that they will, if I try to just, it will be completely disconnected kind of a stuff. I show something happening here, something happening there. But if I show it through animation, it is going to give the same set of raw material converting into tubes, then going for surface treatment, then going for galvanization. So the connectivity, the understanding of the process is very clear. But videography is something which creates the ownership. That will show this is Tata plant. So that is where we have done a presentation like this, where we have started with videos.
Empowered with the latest state-of-the-art technology for the production of steel tubes, Tata Steel Tubes. The quality of finished product. Art, hot strip mill.
And from later on, we are showing in animation how the exact construction, the fabrication process happens.
Automated movement of strips takes them through the strip leveler into MIG welding unit that serves to join together the strips.
Okay, now this is where you have only one video to be made. But say you have multiple videos. Say your entire company has a lot of different aspects. And I say, sir, I'm going to make you a master marketing collateral where there are a lot of, every aspect is covered. Say it like this. You put the DVD, you get a kind of an intro like this. If you skip the intro, you get into the home page. This is not a website, please understand. This is a web DVD format. You can distribute it to anybody and everybody. Plus, if you want, we can make it available, of course. And then this is about us. This is where we are talking about Tata Group, Tata Steel Tubes SBU. Go to Tata Group, you have a video there, you have a text documents there. Then you go to product. In the product, you can have top on tubes, which is what tubes are. There you can also have, say for example in products, you have condensed tubes, structure and precision. Within condensed, you have manufacturing aspects, the video I showed you just, and application aspect, like plumbing. In within the application, you have so many stuff, products, ranges, culture. So what I'm trying to show you is, the videos or the images, these are only the visual content. And this is the container or the content delivery system. And we make both. So we are a complete visual communication company where we understand your requirement of communication. That is one of our basic advantage. I'm not getting into architectural events. I will not be able to manage time in that particular case. The usage of our products, both videos, 2 minutes to 15 minute films, which we make using videography or animation or combination of both, and these interactive products, 4Tech, are used by our clients for marketing, branding or media activities, for training, safety, maintenance and operations, for milestone visualization, client presentations, and technical qualification in billing. Like Bandra World has been done, they will bid for World League to Haji Ali, they will use this video. And I have, we are talking to ITC for a training module. We are just going through the vendor registration process. So these are the kind of stuff that we are really going to. These are our clientels, some of them, I mean, not all probably. We are exactly 5 years and 4 months old. And we have some 30 clients, 28 Indians to international, 45 projects closed, 39 completed, 6 running. This is the current. And this is what the ACC has to say about us. I had been evaluating quite a few vendors, but I could not find anybody near to their workmanship. I find the difference visible even now. And this testimony has been received by a friend. I don't know if he has come, Sudeep Samantar. I think he has not reached here. And he is known to quite a few. He was trying to understand what our clients think about us, because he is helping us, take it to the next level. So this is what we do. And one thing I would like to say, we are not trying to sell Mercedes, Maruti. In terms of quality, we are trying to sell Mercedes. So this one point I would like to just make a note of. And the reason he would come back to us is, engineering sense that we put in the entire concept. And honestly speaking, don't think that engineering is not there in even selling what is that called, Mudi Khana kind of stuff. And near natural visualization quality, I have already given you the entire thing. Say for example, this is the MNP jacket, the real video, which was shown how the jacket has actually fallen when it was erected. So this is the real jacket videography which has when it was fallen, from which we have created the film. So this has been constructed in Oman, taken to the real in Bombay High, and they are making it fall there. This is the last slide, so I'll be ending in 35 seconds more. This is what we are trying to do.
Charge his balusters and debalusters to create a tilt of around 3 degrees. This tilt initiates the scaling of
this
the
jacket. And including this tumbling of the
vertex structure smoothly.
Okay, and two more reasons, the comfort factor. The client come back to us because he doesn't have to worry. They have to only tell us purpose, their audience, and what is the process. Rest is my responsibility. That is, communication goes well. Technology and process optimization with respect to cost, time, and everything. And the cost factor, being in Calcutta, I could say we are at least 40% cheaper than my next level of competitors in India. And at least, you know, we are one third to the prices of Singapore and so this is what I have to say. If you want, you can visit my website, but rather I would request you to go to YouTube and type Anthelian Technology. Instead of talking big in the website by myself, you see the work there that will talk about itself. That's it. I think that is.
Specific